gonna go with a big scoop today.
What's up, guys? It is day 7, week 2 of the Carolyn O'Mahony Fitness Challenge. I am currently pounding my Neuromorph. That mango tea is way too good. And I definitely have some cinnamon bread here, just as like a little breakfast snack. I actually had to switch my rest day 7, which was supposed to be this rest day, for day 6. I got my lip filled, and so I wasn't able to work out for 24 to 48 hours. So I really had to just take the time to like put everything aside and focus on letting myself heal for the day. So today we're gonna go really hard. We're gonna do part of day 5 and all of day 6, just because I really, really wanna really kill it today. I've got my Hydrate Spark here. If you don't know what this is, you should get one. They have them on Amazon, relatively inexpensive. It's a water bottle that is tracked by an app, so it tracks how much you drink, and it lights up every time you should be drinking water. And every time you don't, or every time you do drink water, it lights up afterward as it's measuring and re-recording and recording in the app how much water you drink. So once I set it down, it lights up rainbow. We're gonna kick today's ass and make today our bitch. Are you fucking ready? Cause you should be. Let's fucking do it. It's ice cold in my car right now. What the fuck? You know what time it is. Time to get hype. I'm bad and you working with some next.
Wrestling waist with a body on me, goddamn, I'm popping, I'm hot. Real thick bands and a motherfucker pants. He was standing from a stand, so I took him to the spot. Bussy, 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 bussy.
I need a passenger. If anybody wants to volunteer to be my gym partner so we can jam to this together.
My best friend, she a real bad bitch, got her own money. She don't need no nigga on the dance floor. She had 2-3 drinks, now she twerking. She throw it out and come back in. That's my best friend, she a real bad.
Clearly I have way too much fun in my car, but let's get into it. I'm gonna go ahead and put this band around my toes and get into some teeter totters. We're gonna do 2 sets of 10 steps in each direction, 15 if you're really feeling frisky. It really helps open up those hips, especially after resting for like a whole day. It definitely helped before my big lifts. It's become one of my favorites as of late. So I've been doing these a lot lately. I like to call them turnouts. They do help quite a bit with your adductor activation. And the best part is they do actually help quite a bit with quad activation as well. And you know the vibes. We gotta do our glute abduction walks every single day. I mean, not even just on leg days. I do these every single day. 3 sets of 10 steps in each direction. 15 again if you are feeling frisky. I gotta build that booty every single day. These bands that I use are actually from Build-A-Booty, so if you're feeling like you want to get some, go ahead and check those out. I used my light resistance band to do some goblet pulse squats as well, because, you know, gotta do that burnout. Gotta feel that burnout in those glutes, baby. Feel it. Alright, glute kickbacks to kill that booty. Normally I would do them with a completely straight leg. I feel as though it helps with that top booty a little bit more, but I was trying to avoid kicking people and, you know, just for the purpose of doing them the way that they were shown to me by this program, I wanted to make sure I was doing it exactly how I was told to, based upon what the program stated. And I threw in a little bit of a landmine cable squat. I love to do landmine squats, you know, that deep push from that seated position, but all the landmines were taken up, so I had to kind of do a little improvisation. All right, barbell RDLs. I actually have a 5-pound plate under each one of my heels for some elevation. I really like doing RDLs with a heel elevation. I feel as though it definitely helps quite a bit more on that upper hamstring area. Just personal preference. And then we are going to do some barbell low rows. You'll see I only have one wrist strap on. It's because I broke my right hand, so I only use one wrist strap. Hydration check, baby! All right, and we're getting ourselves into some pull-ups. 3 sets of 5 was kind of hard for me. It's hard for me to do pull-ups because of my hand, honestly, but I make it happen. close, stance, leg press. I did these really light today, but I did some really big sets. I was doing like sets of 20. Just really good for the hamstring, really good for the glutes, especially close stance. And then immediately following this, I supersetted it with single legs, leg press, which also really, really good for your glutes, really, really good for your hamstrings. Definitely puts a lot of pressure on your adductors and abductors because you are solely using one leg. So definitely something to try if you haven't. And here I am just feeling myself, thinking I got a big old butt, you know, trying to make myself feel like a bad bitch. What's up? All right, and then we have some Smith Machine Sissy Squats. I love to do Smith Machine Sissy Squats just because I feel like it helps so much. And you get to focus a little bit more. You get a little bit more control than normally, like trying to do Sissy Squats with the bar. Sweat check. Girl, you already know we sweaty and we ready. We are on the abductor machine, 3 minutes straight. Just go ham. And then we did get into some hip thrusts today. I didn't use a barbell. I decided to use this one just because I was already past the point of exhaustion, so I lightened my weight up quite a bit today. It was just one of those days. And, of course, we feeling like a bad bitch. We walk out the gym. We got Big Booty Judy, Big Gun Sammy, like, what's up? Whoo, look at them angles, girl. Oh, yes. Really feeling myself.
I already know. Protein. I don't know. It's really hard to chug this. But we're doing it.
I hope you guys enjoyed the workout. I honestly feel freaking great after today, and I am really excited for week 3, honestly. Pretty freaking pumped.
Hey guys, it's officially day 1 of week 3, so we're gonna take our measurements after our 2-week progress. Obviously, we're gonna start with my favorite part. Where? 38. Right there. 27. No, 35 and a half. No, 36 if I breathe out. Okay, so gained a half inch of glutes. We lost a half inch in the chest. And my waist stayed pretty much the same, I think. So, we'll see where we're at in 2 weeks. All right, if you have any questions, comments, concerns, drop them down there. My Instagram is Rayleigh with a 3 instead of an E, or tattedfitchick_. Thank you again for watching my videos. Please like, share, and subscribe. And I hope that you all have a beautiful day.